So they got back to me a few days before and said, we are having a two-day session with Danny Tom. So I said, yes. And so I'm here. But as I know, I didn't want to speak, she gave me, I'm going to speak about this, I just gave me. So as I was driving the car from my head to here, there was only one thought which overpowered me. So I'm going to talk only that. I'm not going to be any personal anything. I was asking, why am I coming here? I was asking to myself, why am I coming here? But that question disappeared. Immediately another question came, why are about 80 people here on a Sunday? I am 80 plus 1, 81. Or 80 plus 84, 84, whatever. So I was asking, why would not only you, I think it includes me, it includes Ramon, it includes Disha, it includes Meera, everyone. The question is, why are we here on a Saturday and a Sunday? I want only all, try to answer this question. For a simple reason, there are 1,000 things to know. I don't think all of them are bad. Some of them may be as good as what we are doing here. So when there are 1,000 things to do for all of us, I was asking, why did I say yes to her and why are I coming here? And for the same reason, why are we here trying to spend 2 days? 80 of you spending about 2 days is a good 1,300 man hours of thinking, 1,500 man hours of thinking, or woman hours, however you want to say. Person hours being spent in a room. That's enormous energy here in the last 2 days. So I was asking, why are we doing this? Because much of our going forward depends on the trying to understand this question for ourselves. Why are we here? Rekha told me that, it's part of that volunteering from, we keep doing it from time to time, so a number of very good people and all that we told. So why do we want to? So the question is, what attracted us here? So I was, this was the line of thought. To talk an hour for me, she asked me to speak for half an hour. I thought for half an hour. I think somehow we manage. So I asked, after some thinking, I said, maybe we want to give something. So the moment you say you want to give, there are two things which come to my mind. First, there is one nice shloka. Hitopadesh. The shloka says, Sahasreshu, Vaktachu Sahasreshu. You can see a good speaker, one in the Shura. I think Sahasreshu is a Shura. One brave person, you will mind one in 100. One in 100. Sateshu Shura. Sahasreshu is a Pandita. Some learned person, one in 1,000. That's also possible. Bhakta Dasadhastiration. Who speaks well, aptly, that can be only 10,000. Then the shloka says, Datha Bhavativa Nava. We don't know whether there are people who are willing to give. That is the shloka. The shloka says, you will find 1 in 100 who is brave, 1 in 1,000 who is a Pandita, 1 in 10,000 who will speak very aptly, then the shloka is saying, I do not know whether there are people who are willing to give. Because we have chosen to give. That's why we have come. So, going by the shloka, I think we have only 10,000. But more than only 10,000. Maybe only in shloka. You can start that. Because that shloka came to my mind. There is another episode which you find in Brihadaranyaka Upanishad. That also came to my mind. There's a very famous episode called Da Da Da. I don't know how many of you know that. Da 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 is the sound of the thunder. Upanishads are only supposed to look very highly intuitive, very deep. So this da 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 sound. So Prajapati wanted to know, what is this da da da? He uses da 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 three times. You see, it is the sound of the thunder. First he goes to Devas. What do you understand by this sound da? Then Devas said, da means dama. So we are enjoying too much. We need some dama. We need some restraint. Sensory control. This is what we have understood as da. Da. Prajapati said, all right. Then Prajapati went to Rakshasa and asked, what do you mean with this da da da? Da means daya. We are so poor. We should exhibit a little bit of daya. That is what we have understood. So Prajapati said, fine. Prajapati went to Manishyas to ask, what do you understand by this da da da? Manishyas, da means dana. We are not giving that way. Data Bhavatiwa Dava. So the first thing that came to my mind is we have taken a conscious decision to give. That is what Seva is, according to me. It is a conscious decision to give. Now the question is, what do you want to give? Or what is easy to give? My thought process started going in that. I found what are the easiest thing to give. The easiest thing to give into anyone is Gali. No cost involved. Straight. Then slightly difficult than that is giving others. That's also easy. There is somebody going to give. Listen, they can keep on giving advice. Right? Then the third in that order, easy to give, is giving useless things in the name of Dhamma. Please don't get me wrong. I know that powder of booj. Okay? So once we were sitting and talking, he told me something which just shattered my heart. Because this is what many of us are. We don't belong to that, but I still want to say this. There was this huge, this happened around the time when there was this huge threat in the Mantralaya. You know what this booj powder told me? He said, sir, the amount of money that we have to spend to dispose of things that we receive because they are absolutely useless, cannot be given to anyone. This is what people give. Broken toys, torn shirts, truckloads of material we didn't know how to handle it. So that's why giving what I find useless is the next easiest thing. Or next difficult, I have said there are a lot of difficult, the next difficult thing. Even difficult than that is giving money or giving a brand new shirt or good toy which can be used and so on. Now, see, why are people doing that? Because people lack empathy. See, there are two words in English, sympathy and empathy. Nobody wants sympathy. Sympathy requires force of gravity. The other person on whom you sympathize, you think he is lower than you, he or she is lower than you. It is up to you with all your ego, you have to only then the emotion called sympathy can come. Whereas the emotion called empathy will come when I think of about the state like the other person. If only I thought about the difficulty of the floods that caused in Mantralaya, I would have never given that kind of thing. A person with the empathy will never do that. Just imagine, I live in a very comfortable house in IIMB in Bangalore. By bad stroke of the nature, there is an earthquake in the middle of the road. I'm going to tell me, I have a 2-year-old daughter, let us say, she's going to play with broken guys, I'm going to have some town shirts. I will eat some spoiled food. Why are we thinking like that? So, giving useless things already is hard. None of people do that. Even difficult than that is giving useful things, giving money. But the toughest of giving, of all these, if you really ask me, is to give time and mention. I can write a check and give it to you, but you ask me to come and spend 2 days. So this is the gradation of giving, from value on one side, to giving time and mindset. In Sanatana Dharma, and think that is the greatest pedestal on which we have put this emotion of Danam. Go to the village, you understand, in the city, we don't see. See, Warren Buffet came to India. Warren Buffet said the Indians are not coming here. My good friend Vaidyanathan, professor at the IIMB Bangalore, wrote an article. He said, you don't know what you mean, you should not tell what we are doing. But if all these tip of the iceberg, not even tip of the iceberg. You go to the village, you understand what people give. They put a stone. If somebody is carrying a weight, they should leave their weight there. They actually, in the memory of their father, grandfather, they actually set up a buttermilk pandal for 2 months in summer. But ideas are very great. So, if you ask me what is this seva, seva is, according to me, in very simple terms, a conscious choice that we have taken to give time and mind share, which I don't think ordinary people can do, only extraordinary people can do. This is a matter of extraordinariness, not in terms of the wealth or knowledge or nothing. This is something which is very uniquely endowed to only a few individuals, not all. It endowed only to a few individuals, not everybody can do. But that is the reason why I am here on Saturday and Sunday. By making this choice to come here on Saturday and Sunday, there is the signal. I don't know whether we thought about it or not. There is a signal that we are part of that chosen few by the God. This is my own understanding. So we ask, what is the seva? Seva has, according to me, three dimensions. The first dimension is a conscious choice to give time and mind share. It's extraordinarily difficult. When somebody has done it, there is a reason why we learn. I'll talk about it a little later. So the first attribute of seva is the conscious choice I have made to give time and mind share. Because without time, mind does not come. Without mind, time does not come. Both are coexist. That is the first definition of seva that I have understood. The second definition of seva that I have understood is it draws from the Sanatana Dharma principle of Danam. See, the Indian concept of Dharma, seva is giving. That's why, you know, in all the, in this country, any Danam that is done, any yajna that is done, you will find the Purohit will say, Prajapataye idam namama. That's what it will say. Agneye idam namama. Namama, namama will come all the time. See, the biggest difference from giving, which we are practicing, because we are imbibing Western cultures today. The biggest difference between giving that we are practicing today and giving as Sanatana Dharma has started, there are very important differences. The first, I want to talk about the most important difference. There is a difference between giving and giving up. The Indian concept of giving is giving up. Means, after you give, there is no return gift possible. In fact, if you take return gift, the sapalata will not be there. This is of samskara, this is of samskriti. Whereas today, there is this Western concept of giving. Western concept of giving is very different from the Indian concept of giving. The Western concept of giving, giving strictly follows a cost-benefit framework. I have put X and I get back X or some Y. So you are, I will invite you for a birthday party. I will give you, you have to give me something, I will give you something back. In Indian concept, it is not like that. Giving means giving up. That is why some Vedanta Ramesha Paramahamsa will say, Daidra Narayana, you have a great opportunity to give. And the moment you give, you have forget whether you give time, whether you give money, it should go out of our mind. It's called giving up. In fact, that is the pinnacle of seva. Seva is to give and give up. So the second principle of seva is an extraordinary understanding that I have taken on to a possibility of giving up my time and mind share for a cause. And the third part of seva, which also inspires me, is the cause. I think of all the ways we spend our time, if our ability to put smile on the face of somebody, that its ability to fulfill our heart, fill our heart, can never be matched by any stretch of imagination, any amount of materialistic things. Now, I'll give you a simple example. I just give you a simple personal example. One day I was going for a meeting. It's a very simple example, just to otherwise the idea doesn't get there. One day I was going for a meeting in my car, where in Jainagar from IIMB was coming. I was 5 minutes already a little behind, I think. I got delayed in my institute and so on. In third fifth cross or 30th cross Jainagar, there was about an 80-year-old gentleman, 78, 80. I was waiting for a traffic. He showed me an address. And he said, sir, can you tell me where is this address? As you know, in this city, there is this notorious B cross, C cross, F cross, there are dead ends. So it was the 36th F cross. And I know the 36th F cross is not here, anywhere near 36th cross. I know it is half a kilometer away somewhere. So I could have easily told him, sir, go right, go there, third, take the third rough, then take a right, take a U-turn. It's on dead end, that is the F cross, I could have done. That day, what he did, I just said, you get into the car. Also, he was late. Tomorrow, I said that place, maybe. He said, no, sir. I said, no, I think this traffic, I don't want him to go. So I took him, dropped him there. I was, instead of going late for 5 minutes, I got late for 15 minutes. For 2 days, I was feeling good. But such a small little thing that I did, I felt good in a very small way. So what I'm trying to say, this is the power of, I mean, this is not Seva that I am talking. It's a very small example, but I'm saying this is this power of Seva. This power of Seva is that our ability to fill our heart is far more powerful than our ability to fill our pocket. Because at the end of the day, as the German saying says, the last shirt does not have a pocket. That's the German saying. The last shirt does not have a pocket. That's why, you know, Alexander said, please put my hand like this, out of my car, out of the coffin, my hand must be stretched like this. The whole world knows that the greatest emperor is going empty-handed. So we don't have to waste time, so we have taken that choice. So I'm extremely happy that, you know, a good number of you have chosen to come here. Right? Now I was wondering, that why did we do it? Still, I haven't answered the why part of it very much. So I was thinking about it, I almost reached this place. So I had come out, I shared that with you. I think there are three reasons why we are here on this Sunday, giving up so many other possibilities, some of them, as I told you, equally interesting, equally appealing. There is a reason why we are here, and the reason, according to me, are threefold. The first and the most are probably this only reason is what I call it as Daivan Uttrila Hetuka. The God has chosen us to come here. I tell you, you cannot walk into this room. Never think you can walk into this room. It's not possible. But I conduct a weekly satsanga. I tell my students, you can't walk into this room. There are only some who come year after year for the last 8 years. But these things happen because, you know, we are the chosen few. So the first reason why we are here, and there is this Ekachitta, is because I think we are blessed to have been chosen by the Lord. Otherwise, no good. I said, you know, there are any number of things that you can do. And however, the number of attempts you make, you will find there will be some obstruction before you are coming here. This is actually a signal of dignity, saying that I have chosen you. I carefully choose whom I think can make a difference to people. And part of that reason is also that it is my nature. It is your nature. I think your nature is to make a difference to people, otherwise you won't come here. I mean, it may be hibernating, it may be expressing in its own way, it may be, you know, resident somewhere. So there is an occasion for it to get sparked. It is our nature. It is our inherent nature, which means that Sattva, Rajat, Tama, Gunas are working in a particular way, that it is my inherent nature that I want to put smile on the face of someone. That's why I'm sitting here from yesterday morning trying to find out what to do. So, this is our nature. I don't think, you know, you will be able to escape the entire Bhagavad Gita. Krishna says to Arjuna in the 18th chapter, finally he says, after all that you run away, you come back. You may say, I will not fight another, you come back. He says, Avasham Prakrite Vashat. That is the thing he says, we are all pratityas vasha, avasham. We don't have control of ourselves. We are controlled by our nature, bhavam tat bhavati. So it is our inherent nature that we want to make a difference to some people in some ways. Disha is a vehicle, I am a vehicle, you are a vehicle, every one of us is a nimitta matram. We are only some instrumental cars in the whole Bhagavad Leela that is happening in this Jagat. And you ask, why did my nature become like that? It means our samskaras are cleaner. Over here, over janmas, our samskaras have become a little cleaner. So all that I would say is, we are all blessed to be here. It's not by accident we decided we'll come here. Maybe we did not come for the lunch or for the room or for the fan or anything, not for the PPT and not for my talk also. These are all just, you know, nimitta. I think there is a calling within every one of us. It is our nature that we want to evolve, because Seva is the only way we can evolve. Seva is the only way we can evolve. This Vyaktitva Vikasa will happen only through Seva. Now we can find out what best I can do as Seva. I mean, Seva doesn't mean to do only in a particular way. I think it is a great opportunity for Vyaktitva Vikasa. We are blessed to be here. I am blessed to know all of you. I think this kind of satsang, I will just quote one shloka from Viveka Chudamani, magnum opus of Shankaracharya. Second shloka, he says, Duryabham Trayinetat. That's what he starts by saying. There are three things which are very, very difficult. Daivanukraha Hetukam, Mumukshatvam, Manushyatvam, Mahapurusha Samshraya. I see all the three here. So therefore I am blessed, and together we will do. I am also part of Disha. I don't go as much as they do. You know, so they have said all that. I am a small little, whatever little I can do, I do. I think with that spirit, all of us can do whatever we do. I think they drive it so well. We are very grateful to them for creating an opportunity for us. I think with that, we do all these because that is what makes us happy. In Bhagadaranya Upanishad, Maitreyi was told by Arjunalikya. He says, you love your husband not for any other reason. It creates joy in you. Love your son not because he is your son. It creates a joy in you. So we do want to do seva not because of any other reason. It creates joy in us. Thank you and
very happy day.